And we break it down into two simple rules. So these are the rules to determine if a compound will be nonpolar. If it follows all the rules, it's going to be nonpolar. If it breaks any of them, it's going to automatically be polar. So we're going to say for molecular compounds where the central element has no lone pairs, no lone pairs at all, we're going to follow two rules. We're going to say first, the central element must be connected to the same elements. That's rule number one. If it breaks that, it's automatically polar. And then second rule, the central element must be less electronegative than the surrounding elements. If it breaks this rule, it's automatically polar. You have to follow both rules in order to be non-polar. So let me give you a quick example before I let you guys do this one as practice. So we could have CCl4. We'd say the central element has the same elements all around, so it follows rule 1A. And then we're going to say the central element carbon has is less electronegative than the chlorines around it. Therefore, this follows both rules, so therefore it's nonpolar. But let's say I did carbon in the center, and I do this instead. Now we're going to say that the central element doesn't have all the same groups around it, so it breaks rule 1A, and automatically, since it breaks any of the rules, it's going to be polar. This is the approach you have to take.